Hi guys, today's video we're going to be doing something that I hope to continue to do, which is show you my book collection through colors based on the month. So this one is for the month of February, so I'll be showing you all the pink books that I have. Now this is in no particular order or fashion, it's just the way that I grab them off my shelf is how I'm going to do them. And if I've read them or read part of it, then I'll talk about it, but if I haven't, I'll probably just say like why I bought it. First up, we have a classic, Persuasion. I started reading this when I was studying for the MCAT at the beginning of last year just because I wanted to read something, but not something that would like cause me to possibly not continue to study for a few hours because I got so enwrapped in the storyline. Anyways, I'll just tell you the reason why I bought this book because I didn't finish reading it, but I watched the movie on Netflix and I was obsessed with the way that Dakota Johnson portrayed this character, and I was obsessed with the fact that she waited 8 years. I don't think she waited for him. Maybe she did a little bit, but like she waited for him to come back into her life. She just knew. She just knew. She had faith that he would come back, and I was just touched. I really loved the storyline. I really loved the romance aspect. They had terrible communication skills, but that's why I bought this book and I started reading it, but I never got through with it. I'm pretty sure the quotes go hard. I mean, it's Jane Austen and it's a classic, so that's why I bought it. And this Barnes & Noble's cover is pink, so book number one. Next we have Never by Jessa Hastings. I just bought this book and I bought it because everyone's been raving about the Magnolia Parks universe, so I have all those books, and I bought this when I bought Into the Dark, the last book. I haven't read the Magnolia books and I haven't read this one. I almost started to read it this past month, but the reviews on it have not been great, so I ended up going in a different direction. But yeah, that's why I bought it. Everyone loves Jessa Hastings, so I thought, why not get this book too? And it turns out no one really likes this book, so we'll see if I read it. I probably will because I bought it, but it's pink. Next, I have Flawless. Now, I am waiting to read this till the summertime because I want to be able to... I don't know why I think this is so embarrassing, but I have a few country songs that I listen to. Just a few. And I want to be able to listen to those country songs while I read this series. I have no idea what this is about other than it's like country-esque theme. But I bought it because so many people have raved about this series and I am in my romance era right now. Earlier this year, I was in my fantasy era. Now I'm in my romance era. So hopefully I'll still be in my romance era when it gets a little bit close to summer, because that's when I'm planning on reading this. And this is pink, so... Flawless by Elsie Silver. I'm really excited. Like, I really want to read this soon. So hopefully it'll get it warmer out and sunnier out and then I can read it. Next, we have Once Upon a Broken Heart by Stephanie Garber. This is pink. This is a part of my favorite series probably that I've ever read. If you know, you know I rave about Evangeline 24/7. I love, she's probably my favorite female character. One of my top for sure. I just love her outlook on love and I love her story. Anyways, I'm gonna try to talk about this book without giving spoilers, so if it seems jumpy in the clip, that probably means I gave a spoiler. This is about Evangeline. It's a fantasy-esque book. It's like a weird, it's not your typical fantasy book, I will say that. But anyways, it's about Evangeline. She has this stepsister that stole the love of her life, and she calls on a fate. There's these things called fates. They're basically like, I don't know, I guess like mini gods in this universe that can like help you out if you have a problem. You're not supposed to call on them or even acknowledge them, I think. But she does, because Homeskillet's heartbroken, and she's like, I know my stepsister stole my man, and I'm finna get him back. So she goes to his church and she's like asking him for help, this fate, and it's the Prince of Hearts. Is that his title? Anyways, she asks him for help and things go left quickly. Now with this book, I will say I had to push through. I really didn't know what the heck was going on for the first half, but the second half had me in a chokehold. I read this book in one day, I think. Maybe two. I'm pretty sure it was one day. I have a reading vlog up on my channel. It's not a reading vlog. I think it wasn't supposed to be a reading vlog. It was just a day in the life. So it's just a regular vlog, but that's all I did for that day was read that book. Anyways, and then I went to go buy the second book in the series, The Ballad of Never After, which leads me to my next book, The Ballad of Never After, which is the second book in the series. This is the UK edition. It's probably a good mix of red and pink, but I'm gonna use it for pink because it just makes sense. This is the second part in that series where I can't say too much, but hey, our girl Evangeline is still going through it in this book, but things are better for her, I will say. She figured out, you know, the reason, if her sister stole her man, why she stole her man. She figured all that stuff out, but she has new problems now. Okay, she's an established girly now, and she has new problems. This is the best book in the series, hand down. This is the second book is the best. This is probably the reason why I love this series so much, and probably why I gave it all the stars that I gave it. The way that this book ends will have you crying and screaming and throwing up. And when I finished it, there was no third book out. Okay, I had to wait. We had to wait. Matt, riddle me this. I don't think the third book is out. What am I gonna do? I need to look. Because why would it not be out if it's on the back of that thing? Hold on, I gotta look this up. Because if it's not out and I'm flying through this book, what am I gonna do? Is the third book in... What's it called? Once Upon... Okay. Is it out? It is out. If it's out, why didn't I see it on my Barnes & Nobles? Expected publication October 24th, 2023. You can just pre-order it. No! 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 I mean, it's kind of good because it's not that far away, but I can't leave myself on a cliffhanger like this. I guess it is a good book for the fall, but like, why didn't nobody tell me the series was this good? Y'all was just trying to gatekeep? Y'all was just trying to leave it to yourself? Oh my gosh, I gotta get the hardback in this. If you read Once Upon a Broken Heart just for this, I don't blame you, okay? This is a part of my 5 stars. I recommend this book to everyone and anyone. It is, hands down, probably one of the best books that I read in 2023. It stole the show. I was in a slump after this. I couldn't think about anything else. I couldn't even eat, breathe, nothing without knowing what happened to my girl Evangeline. Is she okay? Like, what's going on? Which leads me to my next book. And I know what you guys are thinking. Erica, what the heck? A Christmas tree? Listen, they're all pink. Sue me, okay? You knew I was going to figure out a way to include it in this video. You knew I was. Because the original cover of The Ballad Never After is black and purple, the Barnes & Noble's edition. But it just so happened to work out in my favor. Anyways, this is the third book in the series, A Curse for True Love. It came out last year. Really can't say anything because this is all spoilers. But this book was very interesting. It has you on the edge of your seat because you want to know if things are going to work out, when things are going to work out. I remember going through TikTok, reading everyone's opinions on what they thought this book was going to contain and if we were going to get the ending that we all wanted. And the author Stephanie Garber, she knew what she was doing. She scared us so good. And if you go into this book, you don't know what's gonna happen. You literally don't know what's gonna happen until the last few pages. So let that sit where it may. Please read this series. Okay. I think I gave it 5 stars just for the heck of it. But The Ballad of Never After is really the meat and the potatoes of this series. Moving on, we have Float. I got this book to read during the summertime. I have no idea what it's about. I think it's about this girl who like goes somewhere and she meets these people and she's like navigating like her first crush maybe. I have no idea, but I got it because it's cute. The cover's really cute. And I think it's a cute book to carry around during the summer and take photographs with and stuff like that. So I think the author too, this is why I got it. The author, she started writing this book when she was young and she finished it during college or after she graduated college. And if that doesn't say girl boss, I don't know what does. And I want to associate myself with girl bosses. Next we have A Court of Wings and Ruin. I am halfway through. I've decided that I have to restart this book, probably restart the series. I know what happens in the first two books, but anyways, if you don't know the series, this is ACOTAR. I have read the first one, which is ACOTAR, and the second one, which is Akamoth. I am currently on this one. It's been so long though, for obvious reasons. This book is thick. I started reading this before I started studying for the MCAT, and I was like, I can't continue to read this because I was eating it up, so I had to put it down, and now I haven't picked it back up. Fantasy people unite, you know. I feel like it's such a popular series that I don't really need to talk about it, but like if you're new to fantasy and you want a book to read that's like kind of easy to get into the world, I would say this one. It is still a little difficult, but like just keep reading. That's always my advice to people. If you're getting into a difficult book, like just keep reading and eventually it'll make sense. That's what I do. So you won't regret it. I'm not finished with the series though, so don't comment any spoilers, and I don't know when I'm gonna finish it. I was gonna do it over spring break, which is what I'm on right now, but it's just gonna take more than a week, and I don't wanna get sucked into it right now. Next up, we have another classic, Emma. I feel like this counts as pink. Like, it's very, like, even though it's gray, like, there's a lot of pink accents in it. I got this book because I watched the movie Emma, and I really liked it, although I didn't understand all, like, the movie itself was beautiful. Like, the filming, the scenes, I really liked the way it was edited. I even tried to edit a few of my videos, the first ones that I did like this, and I still liked that aspect, so maybe I'll try to bring that back. But anyways, I really liked this film. I'm kind of obsessed with the way that it was, like, directed and edited and stuff like that, but I don't really understand, like, what was the point of Emma. Like, I get, like, I looked up a synopsis, but anyways, I got the book in hopes of reading it one day and maybe understanding it a little bit better, which I think is literally the opposite of how classics work, because I feel like they're hard to understand. But I really like the movie though, and I watched the newest one, not the older one. Next we have Funny You Should Ask. I don't even know when I bought this book or why I bought this book, and I have no idea what it's about. So if you read this book, let me know if it's good and if I should read it soon, because it's kind of short. So those are my thoughts. Next we have Believe Me. This book is pink. This is literally, I think, the last book. Yeah, this is the last book in the Shatter Me series. If you like dystopian, honestly, if you like to read, you need to read Shatter Me. If you like having book boyfriends, go ahead and add one of the boyfriends in this book to your roster. When I say this name, when you first start reading, you're gonna be like, Erica, why the frick would you say that you like him? Give it some time. Aaron Warner is every girl who reads books boyfriend. You can ask any of your friends that read, hey, what do you think about Aaron Warner? We're gonna go crazy every single time. So I had to include this book basically just so you would read the series. Now when you look it up, you're gonna be like, how many books? But they're short. Come on, all of them are pretty much short. I mean, not as short as this one. It's kind of like a novella, but it's so cute. And the story too is like, the plot goes crazy. I don't know how the author thought of this world, but I need to read her new books. I think it's called like a Kingdom Woven or something. I don't know, but whatever. I see it all the time at Barnes when I go in, and I'm like so tempted to pick it up, but I told one of my friends that we would like buddy read it together, but she's working and I'm in school, so maybe one day we'll get to it, or maybe one day I'll just get to it on my own. But like, anyways, I want to read the rest of her work because Shatter Me was a masterpiece. I don't know how she thought of that. I also heard a rumor that it was supposed to stop after the third book, and you can tell, okay, you can tell that like she could have left it on that, like, but it was like the way that it just ended up being better, like complete, like the completed series, like I don't know how she would have ended right there. Like, I don't think I would have liked it. Like, I would have been like, no, we need more. Like, it was so good, man. If you want to talk about a group of kids whose parents screwed their life, read Shatter Me. Next we have The Do-Over by Lynn Painter. I talked about this in my recommending romance books for February. It's not my favorite romance ever, but you know, it is the epitome of pink and Valentine's Day. It's a Groundhog Day trope book, so our main girl character has to keep repeating the book, or keep repeating the book, has to keep repeating the day over and over again until she figures out what she needs to figure out. It's not, I don't really remember too much about it, so I guess that gives my thoughts on it, but I would recommend. I mean, I think you should read, so it's better than being in other people's business and drama. So if you ever feel like, this is what I say, if I'm getting too involved in other people's business and drama, I pick up a book and read. If you find yourself doing that, pick up this book and read it. Next, we have also Betting on You by Lynn Painter. I actually really enjoyed this book. I do like Charlie and Bailey's storyline. I think they're very cute, which they are the main characters in this book. I like the bets that they made, which is like kind of the trope of this book. I also really like how Lynn Painter can tie in serious topics, but also like, and like bring awareness to them, but also keep the light and fluffiness of a romance. I've enjoyed that about all of her books. And yeah, that's all I have to say about this one. It's pink, it's cute, I recommend. Next, we have All That We Never Were by Alice Kellen. This book was gifted to me by my coworker for Christmas, which if you watched that vlog, thank you. But yeah, thanks, Emily. I haven't gotten to it yet, but I do plan on reading it at some point. I have no idea what it's about, but honestly, I'm just happy that she bought me a book. That's like the most thoughtful gesture ever. If there's two things to get me, if you buy me a book, sold. But if you buy me a book, you read and you annotate it, I haven't had anyone do that for me yet. I don't know how I would react. So yeah, anyways. That's how I got this book, and it's pink. Am I gonna say it's pink after every time? Probably. Next, do we consider this pink? Like, it's kind of giving orange on camera, but like, it's like a corally pink, and it has a lot of pink accents. Anyways, I read a good chunk of this book. I'm like right here. It's by Allie Hazelwood, and there's 3 separate stories in this. I remember the first story being my favorite, and the last story being my least favorite, because, like I've talked about in other vlogs, I don't like romance storylines where there's immediate physical connection, and then you have to go back and, like, see if they get an emotional connection. And then the author kind of, like, tricks you into thinking that they have this emotional connection all along. I just don't like it. It's not for me. And that's what the third storyline is giving. I'm gonna read it just so I can say that I finished this book, because I literally am like this much left. Like, that probably will take me like an hour, maybe 30 minutes. So, but that's why I haven't finished it. I just didn't enjoy that part. But I remember the other two being kind of enjoyable. I really liked the first one. The second one is okay too. But the third one, I was just like, from the jump, I was like, I know I'm not gonna like this. So I kind of put it down and obviously never came back to it. But it's like pinkish, it's coral. Love on the Brain by Allie Hazelwood. I like this book. I just feel like it's hard because it came out right after The Love Hypothesis, and I really liked that one. But I remember reading it. I really liked the plot of it, but I felt like the girl in this was a little bit cringy to me. But I remembered liking the plot. That always happens. Like, anytime I don't really like the girl main character in a book, the plot is like actually interesting for once. But when I like the girl main character, the plot's like subpar at best. There's nothing that really like drew me to wanting to finish it other than the romance. So this one was just like, the romance was like, okay. But you know, Allie Hazelwood, like I said, she writes a good book. Can't deny that, because I'm gonna finish it, and I'm gonna probably be giggling and kicking my feet while I'm reading it. But it's not my favorite one by her, and that's what I remember from it, is thinking that the girl was kind of cringy, but liking the plot. I was kind of thrown off. If you know, you know. I was like, oh my, like, girl, what are you? You better run. Anyway, see, I like that part, but yeah. Love on the Brain. We're getting to the end. I'm going to show these books, but I actually did a reading vlog on it, and it should be up before this video, I hope. So here's the books that I talk more about in that. First, Picking Daisies on a Sunday, Practice Makes Perfect by Sarah Adams, My Roommate is a Vampire, and Checkmate by Allie Hazelwood. I gave my thoughts and opinions on those, but I will tell you about my most favorite one. Picking Daisies on a Sunday, I gave it 5 stars, and I can't stop thinking about the quotes. I think that it was beautifully written, and if there is one book to recommend besides, you know, Once Upon a Broken Heart, that series, if I had to recommend a standalone book, it'd be this one. I just thought it was so cute. I had an amazing time reading it. These were some more pink books. Next, we have Emily Henry, Happy Place. I'm waiting to read this till summertime, and I'm saving all of my Emily Henry books. Probably gonna do a reading vlog of it, but like, I'm waiting to read them all at the same time. The only one that I've kind of read halfway through was People We Meet on Vacation. That book was really hard for me to get through. Maybe I just like wasn't in a good romance headspace when I read it. I think I wanted to read fantasy, so I just never went back to any of her other books. But people say some of her other books are better. I can't remember which one everyone loves. Is it Beach Read or Book Lovers or both? But everyone raved over this book this summer, so I'm excited to get to it. Okay, next we have our Christian books. Lastly but not least, we have Live by Sadie Robertson. I did read this book, but I think it's a devotional. I don't really remember. Did I read this one or I read the other one? I think I read her other books. I haven't read this one. I remember getting it because it's Sadie Robertson, and I think that she's really wise, and she is just a mighty woman of God. So why would I not get a book that she wrote? And I've been trying. This hit me a long time ago, like when I first started reading. I was like, how sad would it be to get to the pearly white gates and God look at me and be like, hey, you read a lot of pages, you read a lot of books, but you did not read like any like Christian authors, or you didn't read my like word, like what's going on? So I was like, you know what, I gotta change it up. So I've been trying to read more Christian books just for a while now, and I need to read this because I haven't. But I read her other book, but it's purple, so I couldn't include it in this video. Maybe one day I'll get to this. But I'll show you the Christian book that I'm reading right now, which I was going to include it in my February one, but I didn't finish it. This is The Love Everybody Wants by Madison Pura. I read her first book and I absolutely ate it up. This book is really good, and what I like about it is she includes these interactive things at the end of each chapter. So one of them was like a vlog, and then one of them was like a prayer. One of them was just like, I don't even remember. But they're like different things that like are interactive, and it's not just like words on a paper, which sometimes can be kind of hard, like when you're reading like a book like this, like a devotional, or you're hearing about some person's life. Like sometimes it was cool, and it was the first thing that I've ever saw, and sometimes you just want to see them, if that makes sense. But I don't know, I really like Miss Madison Pruitt. I've been a fan of hers ever since her Bachelor days. I think that what she did in that season took courage It took courage, and I don't care, some people were mad, but I was blown away by the courage and just the strength and the wisdom of God that you could see through her. And ever since then, I've been a fan. I subscribe to her YouTube channel, I watch her videos, I buy her books. This book is really good. It talks about the love that everybody wants, and I think the biggest thing that I've gotten from this book is just like the love that everybody wants is not always the love that you think you need. And I'm a firm believer that the love that everyone is craving is the love of Jesus. And she hits the nail on the head in this book, and I need to finish it. I'm on chapter 12, and I don't think there's that many more chapters left after that, so maybe I'll finish it soon. Give it a chance, give it a try. Her testimony too is also really cool to just read about. And in this book, I think that she said when she started it, she was single, then she met her now husband, so they were dating, then she got engaged, and then she finished it when they were married. What? Crazy. She hits all perspectives of life in this book, and I just felt like I could learn so much from it. So that's why I got this, and that's why I started reading it. Last and the greatest book of all time is the Holy Bible. My Bible is pink, so I had to include it in this video. I actually did not buy this Bible. I stole it from my sister, which is probably an oxymoron, but I wanted it. So she has another Bible, and I didn't really take it. She wasn't using it, but this is the Word of God. It has the best quotes, the best storyline, the best drama, the best everything. And I'm not even trying to be funny. Like, I'm being so serious. Like, if you know, you know. First of all, I just encourage everyone to read the Bible, read the Word for yourself. And I know that people probably get annoyed hearing that and just hearing about the love of Jesus. And you know, some points in my life too, I get annoyed when people like talk to me, especially if you're going through something hard and something that not a lot of people go through. You probably don't want to hear me talking about this, but I wouldn't be me and I wouldn't be the reader that I am today without God and Jesus and just reading His Word. So yeah, this is the last book. It's pink and it's the best book of all time, and it has the best love story ever. Okay, that is the end of this video, and yes, I'm holding this big pile of pink books for the aesthetic and the aesthetic only. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope that you found something that you may want to buy the next time you're out, or one of these books a chance. And yeah, these are all the pink books that I have. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. Oh, I meant to take a picture and not recorded. Okay, really, goodbye.